Today is the 29th day of the 5th month on our Maker's Restored calendar. It is the 29th day of July on his servant Satan's calendar. It is the 42nd Sabbath of the 440 days of the great and the fearful day of Yahweh. It being the 42nd Sabbath parallels the 42 months of his 1260 day witness against the scattered descendants of Israel. In lieu of this, you should pay close attention to what he is going to speak to you through his servant on this 42nd Sabbath day. There are 58 Sabbaths in total that precede the final 10 days of this period of time. Yahweh caused his servant Noah to sleep with his fathers 58 years after he caused his servant Abraham to be born into this world. This means that we only have 16 Sabbaths left to go before the Most High causes the 3 days of his Hosea chapter 6 prophecy to come to pass. In the last video, he caused me to discuss how his servant Jeremiah's yoke prophecy testifies that the year 2016 on his servant Satan's calendar is the year that he is going to let loose his hot indignation. Today, we are now only 2 days away from the first date of the 4 dates that he gave to us through the hand of his servant Haggai. The prophecies that are contained within these 4 dates are for his 2 witnesses, Yeshua and Zerubbabel, and those that will stand with us, and for why he is going to shake the dual heavens and the earth. The first part of the 4th date tells us that the why is because you are unclean before his faces. The second part of the 4th date tells us that he is going to do so through a certain signature ring that he has placed upon the hand of his end-time servant Zerubbabel that he has caused to flow out from Mystery Babylon. Zerubbabel means one that flows out from Babylon. The signature ring that he has placed upon my hand is summed up through the hand of his servant Isaiah in chapter 55, verse 11. This verse tells us, "My word that proceeds forth from my mouth is in the same manner." In the same manner is referring to the previous verse. The previous verse tells us in the manner that the rain and the snow fall down from the dual heavens, and they water the earth, and they cause it to bring forth and to bud before they return, so that they will give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. In this manner, he says, "My word will not return to me void. It will accomplish that which I purpose, and it will prosper in that which I sent it to do." His song that he gave to us through the hand of his servant that he drew out from the waters of Egypt to be a witness against the scattered descendants of Israel at the end of this era of time tells us that he has sent me to you in the following manner. And these are the words, chapter 32. "Give ear to the dual heavens, and I will speak. Listen to the earth, and I will listen, and to the speakings of my mouth. My instruction has dripped down as the rain, and my speech has distilled as the dew, like drizzles of rain upon the tender herb, and like showers upon the grass. Because I am crying out to you in Yahweh's name, and I am setting Elohim's greatness in place. He has sent me to you as a small, quiet voice, per the vision that he showed to my predecessor Elijah. He has sent me to you in the manner of the day of small things, per what his messenger told his servant Zechariah concerning how his end-time servant Zerubbabel would be sent to us. He has sent his end-time son of Adam to a small number of people, per his end-time son of Adam prophecy that he gave to us through the hand of his servant Ezekiel on the 5th day of the 4th month. He explained to us through the hand of his servant Isaiah that that our ways are not his ways, nor are our thoughts as his thoughts are. And then he went on to speak the words of Isaiah 55:11 to us. A simple A plus B equals C tells us that he sent his word down from his dual heavens in order for it to teach us his ways and his thoughts. He sent his word down from his dual heavens in order for it to shape and mold us and grow us in his image. He sent it down from his dual heavens as the unleavened bread of life in order for it to nourish our hearts and our minds and give us eternal life in his family. But you have rejected the image of who he is, and you have molded and fashioned him to be in the image of who you want for him to be. And you have disannulled his covenant, and you have made a covenant with death. The Most High sent his only begotten Son to us in the image of his word. His only begotten Son spoke that the only way into his Father's eternal realm is to follow him, and he lived by every word that his Father sent forth from his mouth. But you have made a covenant with a make-believe image of his Son instead. You have made a covenant with a make-believe Messiah that has make-believe blood. And now we have come to the point in time that your Maker is no longer going to allow you to continue to serve and worship your make-believe images of who he and his Son are. He has finished building his temple of first fruits, and he has sent the youngest of this number to you per his prophecies that he gave to us through the hand of his servant Jeremiah in chapters 49 and 50. He has plucked me from your midst, and he has sent me to you bearing his second witness against you. His only begotten Son was his first witness against you. And his word testifies that his first witness entered into me in order for him to send me forth as one stone per what his messenger spoke to his servant Zechariah in chapter 3. And at the end of his 42-month witness against you, he brought forth the 440 days of his execution of his judgment. Concerning the first of the 4 dates that the word of his mouth gave to us through the hand of his servant Haggai, he tells us in Haggai chapter 1, in the second year of King Darius, in the sixth month, on the first day of the month, Yahweh's word existed through the hand of Haggai the prophet to Zerubbabel, the governor of Judah, the son of Shealtiel, and to Yeshua, the high priest, the son of Josedech, saying, the name Haggai comes from the Hebrew word for feast. How this ties into these other words and the here and the now and the Most High's command for you to come to the place that he has chosen for his name to dwell here for his 3 harvest feasts is awesome. We are now fast approaching the last of these 3 harvest feasts of this era of time. Thus saith Yahweh of hosts, saying, this people say that the time that Yahweh's house will be built, but the time has not come. And Yahweh's word existed through the hand of Haggai the prophet, saying, Is it time for you to dwell in your houses when this house that is lined with cedars is dry? The King James translators and other translators translated the Hebrew word for lined in this verse as sealed, and they attributed it to referring to your houses instead of using this adjective to describe the Most High's house. They did so because they did not understand that this is a prophecy and that it was not referring to back then when the second house that was built unto the Most High was being built back up. Some translators, like the New King James, are closer to being correct. The New King James translated it as paneled. It is a word that is only used 6 places in the testimony of the Most High's word, and all 6 places are referring to the Most High's house and it being lined or paneled with cedars. One of these 6 places is in his blessings that are for those of you that will come to his house at this time and offer up the heads of your separation to him upon the altar that he has reared up in the midst of his house. 3 of these 6 times are in 1 Kings, where it is used to describe the panels of the house that Solomon had built under the Most High, and in each of these 3 times it verifies that it is referring to being lined or paneled with cedars. The Most High also verifies this in a prophecy that he gave to us through the hand of his servant Jeremiah in chapter 22, verse 14, where he also refers to it as being panels of cedar. Yahweh my Elohim calls the boulder design of this altar the boulder design of his house. He does so in his end time son of Adam prophecies in chapter 43. The parcel of land for the decreeing, per these other words, chapter 33, where he refers to his house being lined with cedars at this time, where the Most High, referring to the parcel of land where the Most High has reared up this altar, is lined with cedars. He calls the 20-cubit by 20-cubit border around his altar, and that which is in the 14-cubit by 14-cubit lesser settle, and the 12-cubit by 12-cubit greater settle of his altar, the Holy Holy, or the most holy place on planet Earth at this time. Here is some trivia for you that I have not yet spoken about in any of these videos. When I finished translating the words of these are the words, I had to rewrite the stones that I had previously written upon. I had to do so because some rain had caused the words that were upon the lime that I used to whitewash them to fade. It took me 14 days to complete this project. However, two of these 14 days were my father's restored Sabbaths. So I only actually wrote upon the 12 stones that these words fit upon for 12 of these 14 days. Like I said, the lesser settle of his altar is 14 cubits by 14 cubits, and the greater settle of it is 12 cubits by 12 cubits. This has no doubt got to be another coincidence. Another amazing detail in this is when I wrote the words that became faded, it took me several days to just finish 2.5 of these great stones. I had used a table that I had built prior to him showing me his instructions that he gave to me in chapter 41, verse 22 of his end time son of Adam prophecies that are for the dimensions of the wood table of his altar. And when I wrote upon the stones before making this table, I would get a severe neck ache that would hurt exceedingly. However, he supplied me with the wood for the table of wood that he described to us in chapter 41. And this 3-cubit tall and 2-cubit long table was the perfect height for me to, and the pain did not exist during the 14 days of this historic work. I suppose that this is a coincidence as well. Before I knew that this table of wood was specifically for the writing of his Torah upon his altar, I thought, why would a table be 3 cubits tall? I even spoke something along this line in a video that was called 3 cubits by 2 cubits. I said, are these just random measurements? I said, is a normal table 4.5 feet tall by 3 feet long? I said, this would be a very, very tall table. At that time, I did not know that I was supposed to build this table of wood in order to later write his Torah upon the boulder design of his altar. I did not even know that I was supposed to later rear up the boulder design of his altar at that time. I thought that the 3-cubit and the 2 cubits of his wood table were merely symbolic of the three that were in the 80 days of their separation at that time and the Most High's two witnesses. Granted, I knew that these three were going to offer up the heads of their separation to him at the end of their 80 days and that this would require some sort of an altar. However, I did not know that I was later going to be instructed to rear up the boulder design of Kikwe's Ezekiel chapter 43 son of Adam altar at that time. And I certainly did not know that I was going to need a specific wood table that was going to be built to a specific custom-made height that the Most High gave to his servant Ezekiel over 2,000 years ago, that I would need this table to be able to write his Torah upon the stones of this boulder design in order to not hurt my neck, the same neck that the Most High has placed an iron yoke upon. I knew nothing of these instructions at that time. He and his only begotten son have indeed made my burden light, just like his only begotten son spoke would be the case with him dwelling in me. Back to the first day of the 6th month prophecy. Thus says Kikwe of Hosts, at this time, referring to the first day of the 6th month and the days that will follow it, set your heart upon your pathway. You sow in abundance, but you do not harvest enough. You eat, but you are not filled. You drink, but you are not satisfied. You clothe, but you are not warm enough, and you earn wages, and you put them into a bag with holes. Thus says Yahweh of Hosts, set your heart upon your pathway, and ascend up the mountain, and bring wood, and build my house, and I will be pleased, and I will be honored, says Yahweh. In the last video, I spoke about how building his house in this verse is referring to those of you that will come stand with his two witnesses, and become the planting of the millennium so that you can grow in his image to become part of the latter harvest into his eternal family. I also discussed the wood and such of this prophecy, what it means. This mountain is referring to the borders of the holy holy that he has reared up in the midst of Egypt at this time. Kikwe described the borders of his altar as a mountain to his servant Ezekiel in chapter 43. In the next verse, he goes on to speak, and or else to you, or else you will Turn to your abundance, to that which the Most High has multiplied unto you, and you will behold little, and you will go to your house, and I will blow upon it. What is the reason, says Sheikh Way of Hosts? It is because of my house, in that it is dry, and you have run each man to his own house. This is what most of you are going to do in the coming days instead of ascending up to his mountain. You're going to seek your shelter someplace else. So upon this, the dual heavens upon you will be restrained from the dew, and the earth will be restrained of her produce. Upon this is referring to his house being dry. You have prevented his four servants that are obeying the word of his mouth of food and waters, and now he is going to prevent you of food and waters. Verse 11, I have called for a drought upon the land and upon the mountains and upon the grain and upon the wine and upon the oil and upon that which the soil brings forth and upon man and upon the cattle and upon all of the work of the dual palms. And Zerubbabel, the son of Shealtiel, and Yeshua, the high priest, the son of Josedech, and all of the remnant of the people listened to Yahweh their Elohim's voice upon the words of Haggai the prophet, that Yahweh their Elohim had sent forth through him, and the people feared before Yahweh's faces. In the last video, I spoke that so far this remnant is only the three others that have separated themselves unto him at the place that he has chosen for his name to dwell here, and are standing with his two witnesses, Yeshua and Zerubbabel. However, this drought and the rest of the calamity that will accompany it are going to increase this number in the coming days. And Yahweh's messenger Haggai spoke Yahweh's message to the people, saying, I am with you, says Yahweh. He is with those who have come with his servants, Yeshua and Zerubbabel, to build up his house. You are going to find out that he is not with the rest of you. Concerning this drought, the word of his mouth that he gave to us through the hand of his servant Amos tells us in Amos chapter 4, and I will also give you cleanliness of your dual teeth, referring to your top and your bottom teeth not having food to eat, in all of your cities, and you will want for bread in all of your places, for you did not turn back unto me, says Yahweh. I also will hold back the rain from you when there continues 3 months at the harvest, and I will cause it to rain upon one city and to not rain upon one city, and there will be one portion that will have rain and one portion that will not be rained upon, and it will be withered. In yesterday's video, I spoke about the four possibilities that I thought might be the case for when these 3 months will be, and a fifth possibility that two of the four dates of his Haggai prophecy create. There are only three of these five possibilities that have the dates of both ends of them recorded in the testimony of our Maker's Word, and the beginning of the two that do not or have already passed away. The three that remain that do have both ends of them recorded by the hand of the word of the Most High's mouth are the 24th day of the 6th month through the 24th day of the 9th month. The 24th day of the 6th month is the second date of the Most High's Haggai prophecies that are for his servants Yeshua and Zerubbabel, and those of you that will stand with us in order to become the planting of the millennium. The 24th day of the 9th month is the fourth of these dates. The next one is the first day of the 7th month through the first day of the 10th month. The first day of the 7th month is the Memorial of Acclamations that most of you erroneously call the Feast of Trumpets. The first day of the 10th month is the first day of the 3 days of the Most High's Hosea chapter 6 prophecy that he gave to us through the hand of his servant Hosea. It is also the day that he showed his servant Noah the tops of the mountains. It is also the day that our ancestors agreed to put away their strange wives, and to have this accomplished by the first day of the first month. They agreed to do so during this 3 month period of time between these 2 dates. They made this covenant with the Most High during a time that he has sent great rain upon them. At this time, these 3 months are going to be a time of a great shortage of rain that he is going to send upon you because you would not turn back to him. The 10th day of the 7th month through the 10th day of the 10th month is the third of these. The 10th day of the 7th month is the Day of Atonement. The 10th day of the 10th month will be the 6th and final day of that the 7 days of the seven vials of the seventh trumpet are going to be poured out upon those of you that refuse to turn back to your Maker and obey the word of his mouth? The tenth day of the tenth month is also the day that Yahweh caused his servant Nebuchadnezzar to pitch against Jerusalem in the ninth year of his servant Zedekiah's reign. It is also the day that he gave to us for his scum of Israel prophecy that he gave to us through the hand of his servant Ezekiel in chapter 24. This prophecy flows into Yahweh my Elohim's promise that he is sent the one that escapes from our midst and brings the Most High's five-point sign of this prophecy to our ears. This sign is his promise to us that the servant that does so is his end-time son of Adam. Of all of the many words that the Most High has spoken through the hands of his servants that testify to us that he has sent me, this sign is the most basic and straightforward of them all. In lieu of the simplicity of this sign, it is indeed fitting that the Most High has caused the day that he gave this sign to us to be the last day of the great and the fearful day of his hot indignation. His proof that he has sent me to you cannot be put any simpler than he has done so through the 5 points of this sign and his word that accompanies it. The 5 points of this sign are for you to cover your heads as a sign of coming under the covering and under the covering of under his covering and under the covering of his only begotten son shed blood, if you will turn back to him and do that which he has spoken for you to do. Number two, to put your shoes on your feet for the second exodus that is at hand, and flee into Yahweh's mountains for the day of his restored appointed times. And this is turned into his instructions for you to flee into his mountain in order to be able to offer up the head of your separation to him upon his altar. Number three, to not mourn or lament for the destruction of those who will not turn back from the rebellion to the Most High, rather only mourn and lament one another for your own abominations that you have done unto him. Number four, to not cover your lips, meaning to cry out loud and to spare not with his end-time son of Adam, in order to warn others to turn from the rebellion to him, and to cry out the acceptable day and the year of his vengeance with his second anointed son, to cry aloud that this time is at hand. Number five, to stop eating the bread of men, meaning for you to stop eating that which is not of the Most High, and to feast off of his unleavened bread of life that he has sent this son of Adam to restore and his two witnesses to bear witness to. Concerning this sign, his tenth day of the tenth month son of Adam prophecy and his scum of Israel prophecy tells us in Ezekiel chapter 24, as with Ezekiel, this is to be a sign to you according to all that he has done, the 5 points, so shall you do. And when this sign comes, you can know that I am Adonai Yahweh. This verse telling us that when this sign comes, that we can know that he is Adonai Yahweh, tells us that this sign is Yahweh's promise to us that the one who brings this sign to our ears is his servant. It is willful ignorance to deny this basic reality. The next verse tells us when the Most High was going to send this sign to us. In the day when I will take from them their strength and the joy of their glory and the desires of their eyes and that which they tribute their lives to and their sons and their daughters, will it not be you, son of Adam, that escapes, referring to from the captivity of Mystery Babylon at this time, in that day, and comes to them to announce this 5-point sign to their ears? These verses plainly tell us that the one that escapes in this day is the Most High's end-time son of Adam. Keep refuting this very basic and simple reality and see where doing so gets you in the coming days. It is going to get you smitten by the Most High's almighty ability. And if you refuse to be humbled by his almighty hand and turn back to him once he smites you, it is going to get you dead. Thus saith the word of his mouth that is upon the hand of his end-time son of Adam. Thus saith the word of his mouth that is upon the hand that he gave his writer's inkhorn upon my dual loins in order for me to be able to write his words upon the boulder design of his altar. Even though your rebellion to him has caused him to cause the living waters of his altar to be dry, they are not going to continue to be so. His living waters are soon going to flow out from his altar. However, his 144 cubit tall wall is going to keep you from being able to be cleansed by them if you continue to live in rebellion to the word of his mouth. It is what it is. Thus saith Yahweh my Elohim.